Hey guys, welcome back. So guys, in this video we are going to cover the topic of how to insert data into database with form validation. So guys, let's get started. So guys, in previous video we have created the routing where we are using this employee page. So these all are static data right now, and when you click to add employee, the add form is coming. Okay, so let's go back. So guys, if you do not know how to do all this page setup and by calling by the URL, these things, so please watch out the previous video, which is the link is given into the description. Please watch that video and come back to this of inserting data. So if you already have the form, let's continue with it. Okay. So guys, now we are going to insert the data of this first name, last name, phone number and email. Okay. So these data we will be inserting into our database. So we have already one CodeIgniter database. So inside this, we have to create the table and insert the data. So guys, before that, we will get started with the coding. So let's go to our VS Code and you can find the applications folder. So inside this application folder, view folder, inside this view, I have front end, inside this front end where create.php file. So this is the file which we have called it. Okay. So this is the form which we are using it. So guys, now let's get started with it. So as simple, I'll just explain you in very simple. So this is the URL route where add employee /add, we are calling that into our routes. So I'll just show you the route also. So it's, as you can see, that employee add, it's going to front end folder, inside that employee controller file at create function or a method. So let's move to that. So this is our controller. So let me just close this config. And here inside frontend, I have employee controller run. So inside this, we are calling this create file. So this is the frontend folder create.php file. And this is the header and footer we have included for the designing. Okay. So guys, as we are inside this, and now let's start the coding for insertion of data. So guys, now let's set the method form action, and method is equal to where you'll call the post. Okay. And then we have to give a name attribute for them. So let's assign the name is equal to first_name. And the same with this, name is equal to where we'll give as last_name. And then phone number, so name name is equal to where I will mention as phone. And then the final one which we are going to give is name name is equal to email. That's it. And this is the submit button to save it. And now we have to take all these things and create a table into it. So before that, we will go to the action and call the URL. So let's open PHP and let's close this PHP and let's call echo the base URL. So base_URL. So guys, if you don't know how to include this base URL, if you are using this base URL, you will find an error, but I'm not finding this error because I have registered it. So if you don't know how to use this base URL function, please watch out the previous video. In that I have explained very well. So guys, now let's continue where I will give a route employee /store. Okay. So let's copy this and let's go to our route and we will give here $route route of array in this $store is equal to where I'm going to call the front end employee controller. So let me just copy the same thing and let's give it as store over here. Done. So once you click on store, now let's copy this store and let's go to employee controller. So I have the controller over here. Let's create a function. So let me type function. And this is the shortcut. So let's remove the things which you don't need. And then guys, we have to call your input tags. So once you submit that, you are getting the post method, right? So once you submit the data, click on this button submit, that time you are getting the post data with this route. So let's, with the help of this post method, we are going to get the data of it. So let's create a variable called data. is equal to inside this array you are going to fetch it. So we will assign this and we will tell this as first underscore name, the same thing, and then we will pass the input things. Okay, so let's pass that data now. So what is that? Like, we have to get the is equal to and forward arrow, and you have to pass the data. So dollar this of input, whatever you are giving by the post method, we are going to fetch it. Okay, so same input things you have to get that. So just to show one proof of it, not semicolon, we have to give comma. And to check this one, you can go to the documentation. So one example I'll just show you. Let's type input post. So let's type it here, search in it. So you are going to get here. See ya, guys. So CI input post. So let me just click on it, where we'll move to it, and it will show you the detail. Okay, so this is the thing, right? So let's just remove this highlight one. And yes, guys, so the thing is about that only. So this is the code for getting it. So let's copy this, and same thing you are pasted here. So something, what you're getting, that something. So that something is nothing but your form input name. So let me copy this form name, I mean first name, and paste that input name. So let's paste this 4 times and change the name. So let's make it last name, and the same form name you have to call this last name, then phone and email. So let us just type it there. So last name, where this will be known as phone. Let's copy this and paste it here, and let's type this as Control D and type email and set. Okay, so you are getting all the data. So once you get all the data, if you want, you can echo it. So let me just show you a demo. Let's echo and see what happens now. If not, we will check it. Okay, so let's remove this and paste. So let's get back and reload the page. And guys, let me tell with Prakash phone number, whatever it is, with @gmail.com. So let me just save it. So if you see, okay, it's not echoing that because it's in array only. So to print that, you have to do something else for this. Let's dump it. So let me just change this and tell where dump. Okay, so let's make this and let's paste it over here. Let's go to and refresh. Okay, so the output has come here, right? So this is the data which we have sent. So in first variable, you are having 3 strings, and it is showing Ved and then Prakash and the phone number and the email address, right? So guys, this is the thing which we are getting here. Now we want to save this. So before saving this, I want to validate. So let me just go back to the Google Chrome. I mean, where add form. So over here, I want to validate these things. So guys, for that, let's go to our Code Igniter documentation, and you can get the validation. So in libraries only you will be having form validation. Cool, it's here, form validation. So let's click on it, and you can see that where we are going to setting the validation route. So let's select that, and here the form validation where we are going to set it. So if you can't understand this, you can see the demo once they have explained it. So let's copy this and paste it. So let us just ignore this part right now, and let's set the form validation. So first we will do form validation now. So this is the name, and over here, guys, what we have to do, the first name you have to pass it, and the name which we will be showing, first name. Okay, and this is as required field. You can put trim trim pipeline, and then you can give the max length also in this format. So let us just include this thing only. So I'll just go with this only required field right now. So let's take this last name also from the input, and the same thing copy and paste for phone number and email. Okay, done. So now guys, once this is done, so you have to check this, right? So let's put if condition. So if it is correct, means you have to go, else you will be redirected to the page where you want to show the things. Okay, so if it is success, then you have to paste this inside if condition, the data. So before that, you have to check it. So one thing, form validation, where you will call this run. So if it is success, it will use it. So run function is there. If you want, you can just check in your documentation. So let me just control F and find it. So you can find here, guys. So if it is correct, means the form will be working. Okay, so let's include this only and use it. So let's get back and yep, guys. So let's, once it is done, you have to redirect to which page? The same page called where? Here, add employee add. Okay, so you can use the redirect method to go back, or else you can call this same index function. So you can just call this. So in this, I will tell index function. You can call that same function where index function will be called, or else you can use another method, which is redirect function will be there. Redirect function where base underscore URL function you are going to use inside this, you are going to call this employee add data and paste it. Okay, so anyhow you can use it. So let's use this method for testing and we'll be checking with it. So guys, now let's test this. So we have set the route, and once it is invalid, the time the message should print it on your page. So let's get back here and let's see it. So you want to show a message that it is invalid, so let's paste it below. So let's tell small tag where inside this I want to show the error page, I mean error. So for that, we have one form error in CodeIgniter. So let us just see this. Let me just find it in the form validation only. So we are inside the form validation. And yep, guys. So form underscore error. Cool. So this is the thing which we are getting it. Form error function is there. Yes, guys. Showing errors individually. So we will show this error individually. So let me copy this and let's paste that. Done. So instead of first name, username, we will show first name, because this validation, I mean this thing is coming from here. So this will take first name and call that over here. That's it. So let's copy this and paste for everything. So we will be changing this names also. As simple. So let's copy and paste. Copy this first name, phone number, email and email. So I set, and now let's reload the page and see the output for it. Let's see what happens now. Okay, there is an error called form error. Okay, undefined function. So which means this thing is not included. So let's include this in our autoload.php. So form things, it's not supporting in this. So we have to make it supportable. So let's go to our autoload.php file and register the form inside your helper autoload. Okay, so let me just call this and add form form. Simple. So now let's refresh and see. Cool. So it started working. So this was the change one feature we have added now for form support. Let's close that and let us just leave everything empty and let me save this. What happens now? Form validation is not included. So we have to include this also, where function error handling, undefined employee controller form validation. So for this, set rules is should be called. So let's go back and set this also. So let's paste that. Okay, so what we have to do, we are getting this error, right? So as you can see, that error handler is also not supported over here. So for that, we have to either, let's go to our controller and see. So this form validation method object it is calling, right? So from where is this coming? So you have to either call by this dollar this of load and your form validation with the library. Okay, so you have to call your library thing. So this will be like calling for each function. So we have one permanent solution. We have to go to our autoload.php. Inside that, we will go to our library. So this is helper. So for helper, we have added the form. Where is the form validation library? Okay, so this is the library. Inside this, we will be adding our form validation. Okay, so let's add this form validation and we will be checking it. So guys, if you want to see, I have just searched with here. You can see your callback on your own validation method. So just search this and you will set. You can find that load those library form validation. So instead of loading here, we have to check everywhere. So we will set it as globally for it. Done. So guys, let's move to our controller and you can, let's go to our Google Chrome and check that output. So let's just refresh. You can see it's redirected to store. Why it moved to store? It should go to the form. Let me just check in this. Okay, index. What is the index? It's going to employee. So it's wrong. We have to go back to our create page only. So let's copy this and call this function create one. Simple. Save. And now guys, we will click add. And now let me save this. So we are not entering any data. So let's click on save. You can see the first name field is required. The first name, everything is coming the same. Why is it that we have to change over here? Last name, phone number, and the email address. Done. Let's save this and refresh the page. So you can find the phone number is required. Cool. So you got this output now. So guys, let me just save, just enter one data and let me click on it. So you can see that the last number is not done. Okay. So guys, this is how we can do validation. And now let's insert the data as we have discussed about it. So let's go and insert this form validation. So dollar this of your load. Let's call the model. So we have one model called employee. Let me just tell model. So insert this model, where I am going to call into the single quotes my employee model. So let me just close this. Okay, so this is my controller and my model. Here is the model. So inside this model, I have not created the model right now for this. So let's create a model for it. Right click on it and create employee model dot php. So let's copy the same name and hit enter. This is your employee model. And now we have to create the model. So let's pass this model now over here. Done. So let me just go to employee model. And now let's create the model for it. So let us type PHP. And then inside this, we have to create a class. So let's create a class with the employee name. Okay. So employee model extend. So if you're getting any doubts, you have a pre-built things, everything we have in it, right? So same thing, you have to copy and paste. So let us just copy this and let me close this and I'll just paste it here. So let's rename this as employee model, which we just now created the file. So we are going to keep the same file name. Okay. So let me just save it and you can define your class. So guys, now let's give the command to insert the data. Okay, so first thing, we have to create a public function. So let's create public function where insert employee function I'm going to pass. Okay, method, insert employee method. So now here, which we are going to declare the insert query thing. Okay, so dollar this where db. So this db will be connection is given already in previous video. So if you want to give how to know to insert the DB database connection, please watch out the video, link into the description. And now guys, let us call the insert div function. So which is already defined in your CodeIgniter. Okay. So if you want to know about this, you can go to your CodeIgniter quick start. You can find here. So let me just go to the top and show you. So inside your database reference and quick start, you can find that at the below, this is the command. So let me just copy and paste it. So it will be very easy. So now guys, everything is passed and the data from we are going to get. So let me just copy this data and paste here. So this function will be called into your controller. Okay, so make sure we will be calling this and inserting the data. So before inserting, we are going to create a table with the employee. So let me just give employee, and this table name will be created. Okay, so let me just return this. Once you call this, it should be returned. Done. So now let's get back and create the table for it and get back to our database, and let's create a table name where with the column 5. So let me just create a table name, table employee, and let's click go. So it's still loading. It's loaded, and now let us set this one ID, and this will be integer only. Let's set it to 11, where this will be a primary key, where we are going to set it primary. Let's go with this and auto increment. And then here we will pass the first name, whatever the name you have given into it. So let me just show you where is it that here it is. Okay, so let's copy this first name, same name we have to follow with it. So it is first means first column, second means second column, then third means third column, the fourth means fourth column. Okay, so let's copy this, copy and paste. The same you have to call varchar 191, varchar 191, varchar 19, instead of 191 we will give only 20 limit for this. And then email, we'll do varchar, and this also as will give 50. Okay, so let us save this. Let's create the table, save. It's still loading. Okay, so your table has been created now successfully. So guys, now we will insert the data into this table. So let's get back, and yep guys, so over here you are going to pass this model. So inside this model you are going to call dollar this of your model what you are created, this employee. Oops, let's remove this, your model employee, where you are going to, so guys, let's type this. So if you feel this model is too big, so you can assign this as small with emp. So let's replace that emp and then call your insert employee function which you have created in your employee model. Let's view that. So let's go to our employee model, and now over here you have to copy this function. Okay, so let us copy this insert employee function and then pass it over here. So now over here you're getting some data. Okay, so as you can see that we are passing data into this. So same data I am going to call this. So what data is this? This data is nothing but your this data. So let's copy this and paste over here, and this data will go to your employee model. Okay, so then, and then query will be executed this thing, and then it will get stored into your database and then come back. So after getting back, you are going to redirect. So where are you going to redirect? So let's use this same function to redirect. So let us copy this and paste it over here, and we want to redirect to main employee page. So let us save this, and now guys, we will test the DB thing. So let's get back and refresh the page once again. So now let me just click on save. So let's see, the fields are required, all the messages are coming fine, and let me just save the data. So let's type with Prakash and the phone number and then email ID, things which we are going to pass with at gmail.com. So let me just click on save, and let's see, our DB should be inserted. Okay, so we redirect to employee page correctly. Done. So everything is set now, and let me just check our database. So as you can see now, the database is empty. Let me browse it so you can find that. Cool, so your database is inserted, data is inserted into your table using CodeIgniter. So guys, finally we have created that how to insert the data into your table using CodeIgniter with the form validation thing. So now guys, we will be seeing about much things like edit and update, which we are seeing in this. So in next video, we'll meet up how to fetch the data. So these are static data. We will be fetching the original data into it. So let me just add one more employee, because if you are getting confused with this same data, let me just add it one more thing. So let's tell Om Prakash, where phone number is 8888 om@gmail.com. Okay, so let's just save this. I'm going to insert. Cool. So there is nothing like that in this, and here the data has been inserted. So you can see that data has been inserted successfully. So guys, now in this video, that's it. We will continue in next video about how to fetch the data from database. So thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to the channel and share this video.